Good afternoon and welcome to the Countdown studio. On the very day that way back in 1959, Frank Lloyd Wright's great creation, the Guggenheim Museum on Fifth Avenue in New York, opened. What a fantastic building. Pure white with a lovely, graceful, sweeping stair. Well, not stair, actually, but ramp all the way up to the top floor. And, of course, it's featured all the great artists, as it would, as one of the world's leading galleries, although it's called a museum. So, thinking about museums, what is more wonderful than the Great British Museum? You could spend days, you could take your holidays there a month at a time. It's fabulous. Do you have a favourite museum?
I did want to go to the most boring exhibition at the British Museum, actually. So I wouldn't want to disagree. Babylon, it was just really, it wasn't my thing. But I think the Imperial War Museum in London is brilliant, especially the Holocaust exhibition.
Yeah. Well, that's pretty tough stuff, yeah.
Yeah, but very, very well done. And they've got a lot of artefacts and really, you know, bring it home.
Yes, yes, indeed.
As they can.
The Babylon exhibition, of course, Saddam Hussein, he decided to sort of rebuild Babylon. And he put up these buildings and he stamped his own name on each brick. Now, there's a megalomaniac.
Well,
for
my
you.
Dad's got a brick at Manchester United, so similarities.
Brilliant stuff. Well done. Now, who's with us today? Bradley Cates is back, a student from Southport, back after beating Mark Hartnett on Friday, 111. Good score there, Bradley. And you're joined today by yet another Irishman. This one is Sean Delocry from Dundalk, an IT consultant. Is that right?
That's right.
Now living in Maynooth in the County Kildare, who lives with his wife, Edel, two boys. Now, help me with this, Owen, but the Irish for Owen is?
Owen.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
But it's spelled differently. Let me give you the Gaelic spelling, which is E-O-G-H-A-N, and it's pronounced Owen, is it?
Yeah.
Go for the O-E-A-N, yes. And hello, Oisín.
Oisín, yeah.
That's a little girl, I guess.
A boy.
Oh, it's a boy.
Yeah.
Really?
I thought I knew a bit about this. Oisín is a boy's name.
Oisín, yeah.
Oisín. Oh, is there an English sort of equivalent?
Not that I know of. It's a good traditional Irish name.
All right. Well, I'm chastised sufficiently in order to ask us to give a warm round of applause to Bradley and Sean Delocry. And over in the corner on this Monday afternoon, we welcome back Susie. I hope you had a pleasant weekend.
Yes, thank you.
And, of course, the great Arlene Phillips, the queen of the dance. But in the meantime, let's get down to the business of the day. Bradley, would you be good enough? Let us game.
Hi, Rachel.
Hi, Bradley.
Consonant, please.
Thank you. Start with H.
And a vowel.
O.
And a consonant.
M.
And a vowel.
I.
And a consonant.
N.
And a vowel.
E.
And a consonant.
R.
And a consonant.
D.
And a final vowel, please.
And a final U.
Countdown. Yes, Bradley.
Seven.
And Sean.
Seven.
Bradley.
Adam.
And yes, Sean.
I'll try hounder.
A hounder. What do we think about that?
Sounds very likely to me that you could be a hounder. And of course, I'm wrong. You can't be a hounder. Really surprised by that. I'm sorry.
Bad luck.
Yeah.
Bad luck.
It's a bit hit and miss.
So what does that say? Bradley's in the lead by 7 points, but in the corner, what news?
There are some sevens mourned. A humidor is there, which is an airtight container for keeping your cigars, Nick.
Indeed.
And inhumed, which is a poetic way of saying buried. Inhumed.
Yes. And when you dig them up again, it's exhumed.
Exhumed.
Yeah. Yeah, let's hope there are more inhumes than exhumes. 7 points to Bradley and Sean. Let us go.
Hi, Rachel.
Hi, Sean.
Can we start with a vowel, please?
Thank you. Start with A.
And another.
E.
And another.
E.
Consonant, please.
L.
And another.
R.
And another.
S.
And another.
T.
And vowel, please.
I.
And vowel, please.
And lastly, O.
Stand by. Sean?
Seven.
A seven. Bradley?
Yes, yeah, safe seven.
OK. Sean?
Realist.
A realist. Bradley?
Osteria.
Do you know what it is?
Italian restaurant, isn't it?
Absolutely right, yes. It's Italian for inn or hotel. So an Italian restaurant, typically a simple or inexpensive one. Very, very good.
Osteria, yeah.
Wow.
Very good. 14 to seven. But what have we got over there? Arlene.
Well, there's a lot. There's lease, sterile, loiters.
Realist, tailors, lots of sevens. The 1 8 we could find was earliest.
Earliest, okay. All right. Well done, Bradley. 7 points ahead, and now it's your numbers game. Bradley.
One last, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Bradley. One from the top row and five from the bottom rows. And for this round, the numbers are 6, 1, 10, 2, 3, and the large one, 75. And the target, 842.
842. Yes, Bradley.
Yeah, 842.
And Sean?
And 842.
Thank you. Bradley?
75 plus 6 plus 3.
75 plus 6, yeah, plus 384.
Times 10, 840.
Yeah.
Another 2.
842, well done.
Sean?
And the same thing.
Yep. Have a little chat.
There you go.
Happy?
Yeah.
Very good. So, there we are, 24 to Sean's 17 as we turn to a tea time teaser, which is Ken stole. And the clue, Ken stole this key and gained access everywhere. Ken stole this key and gained access everywhere. Welcome back. I left you with the clue, Ken stole this key and gained access everywhere. Why? Because he had a skeleton key. Skeleton. Now then, 24 to Sean 17. Sean, your letters game.
Thanks. May I start with a vowel, please?
Thank you, Sean. E.
And another one.
O.
And a vowel.
A.
And a consonant, please.
R.
Consonant.
N.
And another.
S.
And another one.
C.
And consonants, please.
M.
And consonant, please.
And lastly, G.
Stand by. Sean?
Try a seven.
How about Bradley?
Eight.
OK, Sean?
Morgans.
And Bradley?
Romances.
Romances.
Yes, very nice.
Happy with romances?
Very happy with romances. Not sure about Morgans. There is Morgan there for a horse of a breed developed in New England, but it's a capital M, I'm afraid, Sean, so I can't allow it. Sorry.
Bad luck. So, 32 to 17, but we've had romances. What else have we got over there in the corner?
Moaners. Mm-hmm. Coulsons, Cargos for 7, and actually Sean might kick himself because you can have Morgans with the E, and Morgan in the Netherlands and South Africa is a measure of land equal to about 2 acres.
Really?
Yes.
All right. All right. 32 to 17, and Bradley, letters game.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Bradley. R.
And the vowel?
E.
And the consonant?
S.
And the vowel?
A.
And the consonant?
G.
And the vowel?
O.
The consonant?
N.
Consonant?
T.
And the final consonant, please.
And the last one, B.
And here's the countdown clock. Bradley?
8.
And Sean?
7.
7. All right. Sean?
Oranges.
Oranges and?
Ragstone.
Happy with that?
Excellent. Very, very happy with Ragstone. Yes, that's a really good 8.
Very good. And, yes,
Tangos. Tangos and baronets.
Very nice.
Excellent.
Yeah, baronets for 8. Senator for 7. Treason for 7. So quite good pickings.
Very good. Fat pickings, 40 to 17. Bradley looking good as we turn to Sean for your numbers game.
I'll probably regret this, but we go 4 large.
Go 4 large.
Thanks.
Yeah, let's gamble. Thanks, Sean. Good decision. 4 large, 2 small. And the 2 small ones for you are 5 and another 5. Oh, dear. And the 4 large, as we know, 125, 75 and 50. I'm regretting it already. The target, 959.
959. Sean?
955.
Bradley?
953.
953. So, Sean?
100 plus 75.
75 plus 100, 175.
Times 5.
Times 5 is 875.
Add then 50, 25 and 5.
And then the 50 and the 25. For 950 and 955, 4 away. Well done.
4 away. So, 959, how tricky is that?
Very tricky.
Very
I'll have
tricky.
Another go to see if it's possible.
All right, we'll leave it with you. Couldn't be in better hands. Bradley on 40, Sean now 24. Have it all here today. Bradley on 40, Sean on 24. Well, no, Bradley, why not? Let us go.
Councilman, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Bradley. S.
And the vowel?
A.
The consonant?
L.
And the vowel?
O.
And the consonant?
M.
And the vowel?
U.
And the consonant?
F.
Consonant?
T.
And a final consonant, please.
And a final V.
Stand by. We'll be right back. Bradley?
Seven.
A seven, Sean?
Six.
And that six?
Famous.
Famous. Yes, Bradley?
Sfumato.
So what have we got here?
I was just going to tell you what sfumato was. Bradley's word's brilliant. It's from art, the technique of allowing tones and colours to shade into one another so you get hazy forms and soft outlines. Lovely.
Good Lord. What else have we got over there?
We've got flouts.
Yes.
Vaults.
Yes.
Almost. And that's almost it, I'm afraid.
Yes, we were well beaten.
Yeah. Well, everyone would be beaten by this.
Yeah.
Sfumato. Very good. Well done, Bradley. 47 points. Sean on 24 as we turn to Sean's letters game.
Sorry, Val, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Sean. E.
Another one, please.
O.
And another.
E.
And a consonant, please.
L.
And another, please.
D.
And another.
T.
And another.
G.
And a vowel, please.
I.
And a vowel, please.
And the last one. E.
Clock time. Sean?
Six.
A six, Bradley?
Six.
Sean?
Delete.
Delete?
Delete.
Yes, Bradley?
Toiled.
Toiled?
Yes, very good. Six is only from this one.
Very difficult. Yeah. What have you got over there, Arlene?
Delete.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Similarly. Yeah.
Tough.
Those two sixes, I'm afraid.
That's it. It'll do. Thank you very much. 53 plays 30. Now then, Bradley, it's your numbers game.
Very much, please, Rachel.
Hopefully more straightforward. One large and five small. Thank you, Bradley. And this time the numbers are 8, 7, 1, 4, 10. And the large one, 75. And the target, 608.
608. Bradley?
608.
608 and Sean?
608.
Bradley?
75 plus 1, 76.
76.
Times 8.
Well done. 608.
Yes, Sean.
And the same route.
Yep.
Very good. So, 63 plays 40 as we move swiftly into a tea time teaser, which is huge plod. And the clue, took a huge plod through the field and carried on. Took a huge plod through the field and carried on. Welcome back. I left you with the clue. Took a huge plod through the field and carried on. And the answer is ploughed. Ploughed on. Stay calm and plough on. 63 to Sean's 40. And, Sean, your letters game.
Thanks. Start with a vowel, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Sean. I.
And another.
A.
And another.
E.
And a consonant.
R.
Consonant.
N.
And another.
S.
And another.
D.
And another.
K.
And a final consonant, please.
And a final P.
Countdown.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Sean?
Yes.
An eight? Yep.
Eight.
Two eights. Sean?
Sprained.
Sprained. You're both sprained?
Yep.
Any more sprains in the corner?
Yep.
Anything else?
Spanked.
Yes.
Lots and lots of sevens, actually. Sprained was the only eight that we could find, but there's kidnaps, parkies, darkens, lots and lots of them.
All right. But sprained is the one that takes the day. 71 to 48. And Bradley, why not? Let us go.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Bradley. F.
And a vowel?
A.
And a consonant?
T.
And a vowel?
I.
And a consonant?
S.
And a vowel?
O.
Consonant?
T.
Consonant?
H.
Final vowel, please.
And the last one. E.
Countdown.
Seven.
Yes, Sean?
Seven.
Two sevens. Bradley?
Atheist.
An atheist and?
Fatties.
Fatties.
Might be a bit dodgy. Here we go.
Fatties. And anything else over there? Arlene?
Hotties.
Hotties, indeed. Anything else? That's it?
No, we like that.
That's quite enough, actually, Arlene. Yeah. Thank you. 78 to 55. Sean on 55. Sean, let us go.
Thanks. We start with a vowel, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Sean. A.
And another.
I.
And another.
E.
And the consonant, please.
P.
And another.
G.
And another.
S.
And another.
M.
And another, please.
S.
And consonant, please.
And lastly, P.
And here's the clock. Sean?
Six.
A six, Bradley?
Six.
Sean?
Images.
Images?
Same.
In the same image. Over there. And in the corner, Susie? Arlene?
Ageism.
Ageism. Wretched thing.
Yes, indeed.
What else have we got?
There is nice seven. There are magpies that are there for seven.
Magpies. What else have we got? Anything else?
Else.
That's it. Very good. 84 to 61. Now then, Bradley, last letters game of today.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Bradley. D.
And the vowel?
A.
The consonant?
C.
And the vowel?
E.
And the consonant?
P.
And the vowel?
U.
Consonant?
W.
Consonant?
V.
And a final consonant, please.
And finally, L.
Countdown. Bradley?
Six.
A six, Sean?
And six.
Bradley?
Valued.
Valued.
Placed.
So what have we got here?
The other six is the dewlap, the fold of loose skin hanging from the neck or throat of an animal or bird.
Yes.
A dewlap.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah. bloodhounds have quite a lot of them.
Yes.
Anything else?
Quite right, no, just sixes.
All right, very good. So 90, look at this, Bradley, nudging 100 there. Sean on 67. Sean, it's your numbers game.
Thanks. We'll try four large again.
Try four large, didn't work too well last time. Right, let's see if we can get one that's a little bit more in our range. Right, the two small ones for the last time today. 2 and 3, more promising. And the four large, 150, 75 and 25. And the target, 466.
466. Yes, Sean.
465.
465, one away. Bradley?
462.
462. So, Sean.
100 plus 50.
100 plus 50, 150.
Plus 75 over 25.
75 over 25. 3.
Add that on.
153.
Plus 2.
Plus 2, 155.
And multiply by 3.
And multiply by 3, which you haven't used. Yep, 465.
Very good, well done. But nonetheless, one away. How difficult or tricky is that?
Another tricky one. I will have another look.
Let's leave it with you. So Bradley on 90 and Sean on 74 as we rumble into the conundrum round, the final round. So, Bradley and Sean, fingers on buzzers, please let's reveal today's countdown conundrum. Bradley, yes.
Suffering.
Suffering. Let's see whether you're right. You buzzed with great confidence. Well done. Terrific stuff. Well done, Bradley. Well done. We'll see you tomorrow. 100. Good score. Sean, 74. That's pretty good, too.
It's okay.
But back to Maynooth.
Yep.
And back to your IT job in Dublin. Originally from Dundalk, but you're working in Dublin now, yeah?
Yep.
Very good. So, my warmest regards to places like Clane.
Indeed.
Is that far from you?
That's in the very near, yeah.
Yeah, very good. Yeah, Clane and Maynooth. Maynooth, big seminary there in the old
days.
That's
right, yeah.
They still, a lot of priests lying, you know, being
not
trained.
A huge amount, but it's still there, yeah.
Still there. Very good. Anyway, take this back.
Thanks.
On your aircraft with our best wishes. And if you're in Maynooth, I suppose with our blessing.
Thank you.
Very good. All right, we'll see you tomorrow. See you tomorrow. Bradley, and we'll see you tomorrow, Susie.
See you tomorrow.
And our last day tomorrow.
I know, I'll be sad to say farewell.
Yeah, before you go though,
yes.
All of these extraordinary jobs that you've had, I suppose the music videos, they're pretty short-lived
yes.
and frenetic. Which
yeah.
one stands out in your mind?
Well, I love doing I'm Still Standing with Elton John because what happened in the video wasn't what was meant to happen. But tomorrow I shall tell you a very interesting story about Duran Duran and Wild Boys.
Yes.
And that was a dream of a job.
Excellent. Tomorrow then. Can't wait. See you tomorrow. Brilliant stuff. Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Stories. Elton John and Duran Duran. That's my sort of generation, isn't it?
And mine.
Well,
and
Elton
yours.
John's still
are you, are you an Elton John fan?
Yeah, of course.
God, he's good.
He's still making music, isn't he?
He is. He is so good. I went to a... in fact, it was Alan Sugar's 40th wedding anniversary, and it was such a party. And then at the end of it, they had that... the Valley Boys, what are they called? Jersey Boys. They had the whole cast of Jersey Boys. And then there's
really?
A thunder of a helicopter over in strides Elton John. He was amazing to see him live. I've never done that.
He's spectacular live. It's just unbelievable what he does.
He had the whole place hopping. I tell you what, he was brilliant. He was standing on the piano.
Absolutely. He jumps up and he's playing. He gets one leg up and he carries on playing. It's extraordinary.
I thought he was wonderful. Anyway, there we are. There we are indeed. So, tomorrow, more stories from Arlene Phillips. Join us then, same time. We'll be here waiting for you. You be sure of it. Good afternoon.